My name is Nicolas Zimmermann from Egalia, and I'm going to present you the status of the compositing work in WebKit. As some of you know, Egalia has been working on bringing hardware-accelerated composition for SVG into WebKit. It's actually an idea that goes back to 2012 when I worked on this initially, but it was a huge, complex task, and work has stopped, and finally we worked on this. We have some updates to share with you. So the state of the patch was the last revision from end of May was uploaded to Bugzilla. It was discussed that there should be a technical design document covering all this work, and I began working on this and soon realized that there are some issues with the design that were provable, not fixable within the old design. So this was accelerated transform support, so really offloading everything related to transform changes to the GPU, so WebKit is no longer noticing anything that accelerated transforms are applied in the sense that you need to relayout, etc. Composited documents with the view box were always problematic, and in the end there were really fundamental design issues with the old patch that are now resolved. So all layout tests pass except for a few remaining regressions that I'm aware of, and we are working on it. And a new technical, a new revision of the technical document is in the works. And most importantly, this is all finally tested on WPE desktop and macOS desktop, as well as on the on embedded devices, and the results are really promising. And I would like to show you now what is possible in WebKit today with the latest revision of the patch that I'm going to upload soon to Bugzilla. And a technical document will then definitely follow with the design description, etc. But for today, let's check out some videos. I'm now going to switch to a pre-record. Nicolas Zimmermann from Egalia. I'm working on the SVG rendering engine in WebKit, at the moment on a project that should bring hardware accelerated composition to SVG, a feature already existing in HTML and CSS but not accessible for SVG, as SVG and HTML CSS rendering are done in completely different ways. And the idea is to unify them and unlock a hardware acceleration for SVG. Recently, for hardware accelerated composition, many bugs were fixed, which allows us now to enable this for arbitrary SVG elements. And I'm going to show you now the difference between the rendering engine in the old way and the new one. So let's launch a self-compiled WebKit from a few days ago. I'm going to show you the SVG document, which consists of multiple Bezier paths, polygons, etc. It's a few hundred. This is running on macOS on an M1 laptop, so it's a powerful machine using Core Graphics for rendering, which already does the painting itself on a GPU, which is a difference to many embedded devices where Cairo is used with software rendering within WPE. So keep this in mind. But still, the question is, how does the actual painting in the traditional engine look like? We can use the Web Inspector to find out something about this process. You can here play with it, visualize the elements of the document, see where they are, etc. You can look at the Layer tab. I'm going to detach this window. It shows us a repaint count. It shows us a repaint count, how often this layer was actually repainted. So there's apparently only one layer for the whole document, which is repainted all the time. So layer count is exactly one. We can see the so-called compositing borders. You can see here that this scene is divided into several pieces, and each of them has the repaint counter showing the same number. So apparently the painting is done such in a way that the whole scene is painted and composited in one step. So the whole scene is painted and then composited. That's exactly how it's done at the moment in WebKit. for SVG. We can also record timelines here, which is interesting to understand what's actually happening when two frames are rendered or in between. I'm going to record some events, and we'll have a look at individual frames. Well, let's take a period with a few frames. We have an external trigger here. It's basically a JavaScript request animation frame requesting the paint of a new frame. The reaction is style invalidation. This is because the animation that is applied is changing the transform property. This is a CSS style property. So style is then recalculated. Layout of the whole document is invoked. Layout is performed, painting the whole document, and then compositing. There's still a gap between this final compositing step and the trigger for the next frame. This is because painting is really efficient here, done on the GPU already. And in embedded scenarios, you'll often find this painting step taking the most of the time. Yeah? And if you go below this 16.6 milliseconds, 60 frames per second, it's no longer possible and you don't get a fluent animation. So we can do better. This is the traditional painting approach. If you now look at the layer-based SVG engine, the same scene. Let's have a look with Web Inspector. We can directly see a lot of layers here. We're going to the Layers tab. There are now 787 layers for this document. We before had, I think, one layer of 70 megabyte, so this increased. And you can see here the repaint counters for the individual layers. If I move them here, it's flashing because it is going to highlight them. For instance, this object here, painted 3 times. It's no longer repainting. These things that are moving, like this one, is repainted. This one is repainted, etc. The airplane, for instance, I'm going to enable the compositing borders. Now you can see the repaint counters in all of these rectangles for each of the compositing layers. You can see that the airplane here in the bottom is actually not repainted. It has a repaint count of 3 and it's just transformed by the compositor. No need to repaint this. Some objects, they need to be repainted for various reasons, so it's not easy to say. From this, keep in mind that it's now showing here basically 700 rectangles with the individual layers. There is a lot of room for optimizations in this new engine to avoid creating layers under certain scenarios. This is all not done yet. The point is to see where we are already. Now let's have a look at the rendering performance. Let's record some events and have a look. If we now zoom into a few frames, you can see that the picture has changed. The external trigger leads to a style invalidation and there's no more relayout. So there is no need to relay out this document, since the animated transform operation is directly offloaded. WebCore is not even noticing that something is changing. It's all done in the compositing step. So painting is a smaller amount here that needs to be repainted, as you saw before, because some parts are static, and then the compositing step. And there's still a gap to the next frame, and it's actually longer. But you would see the speed up more dramatic if software rendering would be in use, because the paint phase here is completely reduced to the repaint of the whole scene in the old approach. So this is promising to give us nice performance improvements on embedded devices. You can already see here, if you only check the CPU usage, 27% average for this scene in the new approach. If you do the very same with the vanilla approach, record some frames, check the CPU, you can see it's higher. Because it does more CPU intense things, such as the relayout, which is completely saved in the new approach. So I hope you found this interesting. Accelerated composition has reached a new milestone where things are complex scenes are actually working. So this has a view box applied. There are different transform origins at play. Transform box support for SVG compositing has been added in order to support these kind of documents. And it's now on a in a quite good shape. I hope you enjoyed this, and thanks for your attention.
Now I'm going live, and it's time to answer some questions, if there are any.